If you want to add a document to your website, it's really easy to do in Weebly, but what you need to be aware of is that there are two different document options. One of them doesn't really work and one of them works just fine. So what we want to do is we want to add a PDF right here for the April 2015 newsletter. And so what we're going to use is the file option instead of the document option. The document option is something weird that's kind of tied to another system, and we've tried it before and people aren't able to download it because they don't have a user account with whatever that system is. So I'm not quite sure what Weebly intended to do with this, or maybe if it's a work in progress. But for right now, if you want to add a document, whether that's a Word document, an Excel spreadsheet, a PDF file, whatever it may be, you can drag this document file to your screen. So in this instance, there are two ways that we can do this. I can come to my list of newsletters here, hit enter, return, and type some text that says May 2015 newsletter PDF. And I always let people know what kind of document it is just so that they're aware. And then I can highlight that text, go to the link button, and choose file. And now it shows the April 2015 newsletter. So we're going to click instead this upload a file. Find the May 2015 newsletter wherever it may be on your computer. Open it. It's going to upload it. And then once we are done, this file should be clickable and downloadable online. But let's see what this document file does just to compare. If I drag this down here, it's going to give me a new option to upload a file. You can click here and choose upload a new file. So let's go ahead and upload that May 2015 newsletter. And it's essentially going to go through the same thing, but this time it's going to show an icon that shows the PDF type of file. And then it's going to give you the actual file name, and then people can choose to download the file. So it's pretty much essentially the same thing. They behave the same. They just look different. I don't want to do that this version up here because eventually I'm going to have 12 of these newsletters to download this year. And I think that's going to get really long if I have an icon for each one of them. But if you're just doing one file, this is a great version because it's more visual and it's a little bit easier to understand what people are going to be getting when they download it. So if you don't want this, we can go ahead and click on X, but let's go ahead and publish it and see what this looks like. So we'll wait for a minute for it to publish, click on the link to view it, and now what they can do is they can click here for the newsletter, and it's going to be downloaded into their Firefox download area, or they can click here, and it's going to download it automatically. See how it downloaded it automatically for both versions? So there's the newsletter, and it works exactly the same. It's just how it appears. So let's go back in and delete this version, publish, and make sure everything is working, and that's how to add a document to your website.